What's up, my savvy geeks? Welcome back to another episode, round two of Deadpool and Wolverine. I'm going to kick this episode off with a crazy revelation for you all. I think what I'm about to say will be the biggest twist of anything that you can possibly imagine for this film. By the way, before I go forward, I want to let you all know, this is a spoiler-laden episode. That means if you have not seen the movie, pause, subscribe, give a comment saying you love me, and then you can come back and watch it. I don't want anyone to have the film ruined. Are you ready? Ready for this huge revelation? I'm about to tell you. That dance that everybody is doing from the opening scene of Deadpool, yeah, he didn't make that dance. That's actually NSYNC's dance from the music video and their live shows, I guess. When that song came out, a lot of us, including me, were in our diapers. NSYNC Bye 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 came out in 2000. I was 8 years old when it came out. Yeah, that's crazy. That I also am guilty of thinking that Deadpool created that dance. Or they choreographed it for the film, I mean. It's everywhere right now. TikTok. No, Instagram, YouTube shows, like all these videos. There's so many videos of people doing that dance. It's gone completely viral. I don't even know if all these people saw the film. When I saw it the first time, it was like a surreal experience for me. To put in perspective, if I ever have a kid, I want to name that kid Logan because of how significant the character Wolverine is to me, to my childhood, and to the adult I am now. I say adult with an asterisk. We're all a little bit of a child. So yeah, when Hugh Jackman came back, it was a big deal. I remember seeing Logan in theaters with my friends. And when that cross fell down and it made an X at the end of Logan, I bawled my eyes out. I ugly cried. It was just embarrassing. Hysterical, crying, snot. Like I was so heartbroken for Wolverine dying. And then all these years later, it was teased that he was coming back. And then all these years after that, he actually came back and I was sitting there watching it. I was wearing my Wolverine and Deadpool shirt. I had a first edition Wolverine PSA or whatever the grading company was, a PSA 9.8, a PSA 9.7. I think it's CGC. I forget what the grading company is for comics, but you know what I mean. I had these graded first edition comics in slabs with me, along with all these Funko Pops that I bought and this popcorn bucket. Like I was decked out. Fully ready for this experience. I was on cloud nine. I couldn't believe what I was seeing. I was just so excited. And I think in that excitement, I let some things slip past me and I missed stuff. You know, I think I didn't give the proper evaluation of the film. I don't think anyone can give a proper evaluation film after one viewing. But I think when I did my previous episode, some of the things I said, I don't think were 100% accurate because I just was so enthralled with everything happening. I was so excited that I actually literally missed stuff. Like I would just be like, oh my God, it's Wolverine. And then there'd be dialogue and I missed it. And I own up to that. That's what happens. I think even when I recorded the episode, I wanted to make sure that I let people know that I have to watch it again. And I still think my rating is accurate. I would give it an 80. I'd give it an 88 on the savvy meter, which is out of 100. And I think that's around where I thought it was going to be once I saw it again. This film from the get-go just grabbed you. It was hilarious. Like I said, that dance scene is gone viral. It's so awesome. Everybody's doing it. And from there, we kind of kick off with where Deadpool's at emotionally. And in my previous review, I didn't feel that the emotional side of the film was as well presented as the first two Deadpools. And I want to walk back that comment. I think it is. And I think it's actually better. It's the point of this film, what drives Deadpool this whole time was to feel wanted, to feel that he matters. And I think that's something we can all relate to. I know I find myself just sitting at my desk sometimes and just thinking to myself, what am I doing? Like, is this really me? Am I happy? Am I on the path to doing something that I think matters? And that's the important thing is like, what do you think matters? Because it can mean a lot of different things to a lot of different people. And I think that's something Deadpool had trouble reconciling with throughout the film until the end when he realized what really mattered, what makes him matter, is his family, his found family. which is why that one line at the end just hits you so hard. It's a really strong aspect of the film, and I take back what I said. What I don't take back what I said is that Ryan Reynolds is, it's hard to say as a plural. It's not plural, but his shtick is what I'm trying to say. His shtick is a little too much in this film, and it does take away from the dialogue of other characters. There are so many excellent characters in this film. Like, if I had to rank all the cameos too, I'll rank the cameos later, but for right now, I want to talk about his shtick, and I think he needs to pull it back a little bit. I know it's all about Deadpool, it's in the title, but I didn't feel like they had a good balance of it here. In the previous two films, even in the second Deadpool film, there's a scene where he's like dying at the end, and you keep thinking he's dead, and it's like, haha, that's a little funny, but then they kept going. It's like they don't know when to stop. It's really the worst thing I can say about the film, because I loved it. Let's talk positive. It's a long weekend. Let's have some fun. Deadpool Wolverine had everything you could have hoped for. I take back when I was feeling disappointed. I don't know if I said it, but I definitely don't feel disappointed seeing it a second time and properly paying attention. If I had to rank my favorite cameos, I apologize if I'm leaving anyone out, but let's do my favorite three cameos. It would be, can you count X-23 as a cameo? Because she had a pretty important role in the film and she stays at the end. I say we can probably leave her out. She's not necessarily as much of it. But then if you leave her out, do you leave the other cameos? I don't know. I consider her not a cameo because she joins the universe after. So I'll leave X-23 out. My favorite cameo of the film would probably be Chris Evans as Human Torch. That's my number one favorite cameo. My second favorite would be, Gambit. So Channing Tatum as Gambit. I actually want to see more of him as Gambit. It's funny because that's kind of like how Deadpool started. It was a character Ryan Reynolds really pushed to bring to the screen. And who knows, maybe Channing Tatum can do that with Gambit. We're approaching the Mutant era, folks. It's possible. So that's my second favorite cameo. My third favorite cameo would be Blade. Blade was sick. I love Blade. And then that little look that Deadpool does. And that's another thing. I think Deadpool broke the fourth wall a little too much. But it's not like that much of a deterrent. Our main villain was Cassandra Nova, we didn't get as much screen time with her as I would have hoped. But the screen time we got with her was very, very compelling. She was an awesome villain. I really liked Paradox as kind of a secondary villain in the TVA as a whole. I just think Cassandra Nova was so OP. The way they finished her off is like the only way you could get her. Like, I don't know why she was content staying in the void, but she was. Emma Corrin is the actor who played Cassandra Nova. She did a great job. The actor who did Paradox is from Succession. He ends up being the CEO in the end. I don't watch Succession, but I saw him on the casting thing. So for those of you who watch Succession, that's who that guy is. I'm all over the place, but whatever. I'm like Deadpool. Me and Deadpool share ADHD. I just don't like the idea of a anchor being. To me, that's so stupid. Because eventually everybody dies. So you're telling me that a universe is going to just die 2,000 years after an anchor being dies? Doesn't really work for me. Like, I think the concept of an anchor being is really stupid, and I don't agree with it. I wish they just kept it, like, I don't know, maybe they could have just not done the anchor being as a concept and then have the reason why the TVA wants to destroy his timeline is because Deadpool did all that messing around. And that's why they wanted to prune it. That would have made sense. And then you didn't have this stupid concept. And obviously this concept is going to be tied into Secret Wars. It's so obvious that the Secret Wars is going to be all the anchor beings from all these different universes dropped on this planet and they're going to fight it out. The last anchor being standing is the one whose universe gets refilled. That's clearly what they're going to do. And it just felt like more of a means to an end than a plot device that made sense. You could have still had the concept of an anchor being, but not how to be where it destroys the universe. You know what I mean? I just didn't like that. I forgot to mention that as things I don't like. There's way more things I do like, though. That Deadpool scene at the end was hilarious, where they're like fighting all the Deadpools, and then you have Dogpool. If anyone knows who Ladypool is, comment on the YouTube channel and please let me know. I heard it's not Taylor Swift. I heard it's Blake Lively, but that did not sound like Blake Lively. There's no way that's Blake Lively. Maybe someone else voiced it and Blake Lively was just in the costume. That doesn't make sense either. For those of you who watch Welcome to Wrexham, they noticed a Wrexham logo or the Wales logo on one of the Deadpools. That Deadpool was actually played by Paul Mullins, I think is his name. He's the star striker for Wrexham. So it was a cool little cameo. Rob McElhenney actually had a cameo too, but I guess it was cut, which is disappointing. But overall, the three cameos that I liked the most were Blade 3, Gambit 2nd, and I'm already drawing a blank. Chris Evans as the Human Torch 1st. The cameos were great, but they aren't what made this film great. What made this film great, if I'm being honest, was Wolverine. Hugh Jackman as Wolverine crushed it. He was everything I could have possibly hoped for and more. My understanding is he's from an alternate timeline where Hugh Jackman's Wolverine, I mean, doesn't join the X-Men in Days of Future Past and they all get effed. Oof, I almost swear there. Can't swear on this podcast because then I can't have comments on YouTube. That's actually fact. You got to put the not kid-friendly thing if you're going to have comments. The action was epic. The fights between Deadpool and Wolverine were so good. The van scene was awesome. The scene at the very, very beginning when they're fighting in front of 20th Century Fox. Oh my God, I can't talk right now. The fight scenes between Deadpool and Wolverine were all time for me. I just loved the one in the van. That was hilarious. I love the one in front of 20th Century Fox symbol. And when they first come to the void, they just F each other up. That was great. The final Deadpool fight, like I mentioned, was the best one. I would go, that's my favorite. Then the van scene's 3rd, and the fight when they first get to the void is 2nd. One thing I notice is, okay, so this timeline is the same timeline as Logan, which means that when Deadpool takes place, like the current time of Deadpool, there is a Wolverine in that universe, which means there's a child version of X-21 or whatever, X-23, I mean. So right now, when we see the characters at the end, they're having that final dinner scene. You have an adult X-23 and a Hugh Jackman's Wolverine, right? At that same time, there is a child version of X-23 and a young version of Logan happening. I just think that's a little strange. How adorable is Dogpool, by the way? Adorable meaning ugly, but in a cute way. They should do a plush of Dogpool. I would actually buy a plush of Dogpool, would you? Let me know in the comments. Wolverine and Deadpool, to sum up, had great action, great heart. Wasn't perfect. It had its flaws, but the strengths were so strong that I still have to give it a high rating. That final climax of the film where Deadpool and Wolverine are like, they both decide to make the sacrifice. Like, it was almost like a Black Widow Hawkeye thing where they're fighting over who makes the sacrifice. Then Deadpool decides to do it in the end. And then he's like trying to complete the circuit of the antimatter matter thing, but then he can't reach the other side. And that's when Wolverine grabs his arm and stabs the thing, and they end up making the circuit. And that's when Madonna comes on, Like a Prayer, which has been the whole like kind of theme premise of the, not premise, the heart, the spine of the film. Like, there's throughout the whole film, you have like hints of the song, and it's in the big part of the trailer and all that. So that plays, and Wolverine's shirt rips off, and he's just so shredded. It's so funny. There's so many funny points in the movie, too. Ugh. I think Deadpool, and then after that, Deadpool says, hold hands while listening to, I'm paraphrasing, but he says something like, we were holding hands while listening to Madonna. We're effing indestructible. They come out, and just the music and the slow motion walk with Wolverine's shirt off. The girl that was there was just like, oh my God. The chubby guy that was there was like, oh. They all just like are in awe of Wolverine's jackness. Hugh Jackness? Deadpool Wolverine, you hold a special place in my heart. I'm not even done seeing you in theaters yet. What a great way to kick off the mutant era of the MCU. And you can't kick off the mutant era of the MCU without paying homage and saying a thank you to the X-Men and the mutants of the past, which is what they did in a beautiful montage to Green Day's Time of Your Life. Now that the mutant era actually is here, though, I gotta warn you, Marvel, you got some big shoes to fill. This is Mark Savvy of Savvy Geeks signing off to my new remix that just came out today. See you next week, folks.